Welcome to Sports Central. I'm Kevin Cuenca. Coming up, the Halos hit the Big Apple. The Cavs look to stay postseason perfect. And an injury knocks a star out of the Ducks-Predators series. But we start with some bad news for the Dodgers. Third baseman Justin Turner is the latest player to hit the disabled list after suffering a hamstring strain in last night's win over the Marlins. He's expected to miss a couple weeks. Dodgers looking for their third straight win tonight. Alex Wood is just tearing it up lately. Streak of 13 scoreless innings coming in, and Wood keeps it going tonight, adding another 7 1/3 shutout innings along with 4 strikeouts. The Blue Crew leading 5-0 in the eighth when the rookie Cody Bellinger drills a 2-run bomb, his 8th of the year, the fastest to reach that number in franchise history. Dodgers up 7-0. It gets wild in the ninth. Ross Stripling throws behind Giancarlo Stanton. He's ejected immediately. Bench is clear. Dodgers former skipper Don Mattingly getting into it with Dodgers bench coach Bob Guerin. Both get tossed after the mosh pit. Dodgers win 7-2. The Angels with 4 straight wins coming into tonight's tussle with the Mets. They trailed 2-0 into the seventh before loading the bases with no outs. But Jacob DeGrom gets out of it. Cameron Maben flies out to end the threat there. DeGrom strikes out 9 and in 7 scoreless innings. Then in the bottom half, Michael Conforto looking comfortable at the plate. Takes Jose Alvarez deep for a solo shot. Halos fall 3-0. Celtics guard Isaiah Thomas says he isn't afraid of the Cavs. Hey, they aren't the Monstars, that alien basketball team Michael Jordan and Bugs Bunny faced in the movie Space Jam. The only problem, the Monstars actually lost, something Cleveland had yet to do this postseason. LeBron and the Cavs coming into Game 2 riding a 9-game winning streak in the playoffs. Second quarter, Cavs already up 50-22. LeBron knocks down 3 of his 22 first half points, finishes with a game-high 30. Moments later, former Bruin Kevin Love throws down 2 of his 21 points. Get up, big fella. It's 61-24. Closing seconds of the first half, J.R. Smith drains the buzzer beater here. Cleveland led by 41 at the break, the largest halftime playoff lead ever, and wins 130-86. LeBron James.
We can get better.
Ducks and Predators are down to a best of 3 in the Western Conference Finals, starting with Game 5 tomorrow night. In Anaheim, and Nashville's without its top playmaker. Center Ryan Johansson is done for the playoffs with a thigh injury after leading the Preds in points this postseason. Corey Perry was the hero last night in Game 4, scoring his 3rd overtime winning goal of the playoffs after the Ducks blew a 2-goal third period lead. But the Ducks have been resilient all playoffs, with 6 of their 10 wins coming after trailing. A trait they think will pay off. Game 4 in the East Finals. Penguins trying to even things up against the Senators as Sidney Crosby assist gave Pittsburgh its first goal. Then in the second, Crosby scores on the power play, his 6th goal of the playoffs. Penguins win 3-2 to tie the series at 2 games apiece. 2 of the top names in golf having 2 very different days at the Byron Nelson Classic. We'll show you what went down in Texas when we come back. 7 years ago, a 16-year-old Jordan Spieth made his first appearance on the PGA Tour, finishing tied for 16th as an amateur at the Byron Nelson Classic. He's never finished better in the 5 starts he's made since. The Dallas native starting the day at 2-under. He was on his way to making the cut at 1-under through 15 before falling apart on 16 after hitting his first tee shot out of bounds. His second coming in hot. He'd quadruple bogey, missed a cut by a stroke at 3-over. Dustin Johnson making a run up the leaderboard, firing his 2nd straight 67, including a birdie here on 5, set up by a beautiful tee shot. He's at 6-under. Jason Kokrak leads at 12-under. As if Tom Brady's life wasn't cool enough already, now he's partnering with Aston Martin to design a car. They're creating a limited edition Vanquish with only 12 available for sale. The company's also paying Brady to unbutton his shirt and drive the DB11, which sells for more than $200,000. And he's still married to Giselle. Rough life. That's going to do it for us tonight. Thank you so much for hanging out. We'll see you next time right here on SportsCenter.